Well, despite the overwhelming support of the lower house, one of the seven lawmakers who voted against the bill on constitutional convention stands by his vote. Committee Nisur Representative Gabriel Bordado insists it would be hard to limit constitutional amendments to just economic provisions should the CONCON push through. He points out the CONCON will act as an autonomous entity that could eventually change political provisions in the 1987 charter. Bordado adds there's also no guarantee that amending economic provisions will lead to sustainable growth for the Philippines.
We should first set our sights towards remedying these urgent and continual problems na talagang hinaharap ngayon ang ating bansa.
Mm-mm.
So, amending the 1987 Philippine Constitution could eventually lead to more foreign investors. Ako'y naniniwala dyan. Pero, ang kahirapan nito, we cannot pin all our hopes on the prospect that foreign investments alone would be the key to escaping our economic rut. Sustainable growth would not be possible if we fail to address the pressing concerns already threatening to overwhelm us now.
The family of slain broadcaster Percy Lapid welcomes the indictment of suspended prison chief Gerald Bandag and several others over Lapid's killing and that of Bilibid inmate Jude Villamor. Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla said they have enough evidence to file the cases. The Mabasa family laid down their possible next steps.
Wala pang jurisdiction yung korte nito. Kailangan mahuli muna sila at ma-arraign. Okay? Mag-plead sila ng guilty or not guilty. Mm-hmm. And then tuloy-tuloy na yan. Yung pag-handle ng kaso nito on the part of the prosecution, since this is a case of people of the Philippines versus this accused, ang lead prosecutors dito dapat yung mga analog prosecutors or yung sa DOJ.
As for Bantag's camp, they said they will file the necessary pleadings after reviewing the resolution. The Maritime Industry Authority stands by its claim the sunken tanker that caused the massive oil spill in Oriental Mindoro was not authorized to sail. This after the Philippine Coast Guard released a copy of the Certificate of Public Convenience issued to MT Princess Empress to counter the claim. But Marina says the process of amending the CPC application is not yet completed, as the company also failed to secure a temporary permit.
Ang Philippine Coast Guard po, siya po ang nagko-conduct po ng pre-departure inspection po ng lahat po ng mga barko na lalayag. So sila po ang may authority po doon sa pag-onboard para po i-check kung ang isa pong barko ay authorized po. Meron po siyang safety at trading document. Yung kumpanya po, yung RDC, Rail Marine Services Incorporated, meron po siyang valid na CPC or Certificate of Public Convenience.
Okay.
Kaya lang po, kasama po sa proseso, bago po mag-operate po ang isa pong bagong barko, i-add po yan sa kanya po ng marina na hindi pa po na-i-add ito pong tanker, Princess Empress, doon po sa CPC ng kumpanya.
The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency takes back its claim there's a prevailing practice of rewarding informants with confiscated drugs in successful operations. See, it was PDEA Director General Moro Virgilio Lasso who made that claim, but in a Senate hearing, he clarified it's not being observed in the PDEA reward system.
I acted in good faith when I brought to light the reprehensible act of tipsters seeking confiscated drugs as a reward. But I have never imagined that my sincere intention will be misunderstood. I was only relaying my personal experience about my encounter with some of the informants. I want to make it clear that their proposals were rejected outright. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency wants to correct the erroneous impression that there is a PDEA policy involving the handing out of non-monetary incentives like recycled illicit drugs. To the best of my knowledge, it has never been a prevailing practice in the PDEA reward system.
Senators, meanwhile, say the PDEA chief could have done more to ensure there's no such practice.
It's possible na yung sinasabi ng asset kay DG Lasso may katotohanan. We have to accept our fault, our weaknesses. Lang sa gayon, doon naman natin masosolve ang isang problema. Maaring may katotohanan, imbis na babanggain nyo, we have to investigate.
This committee is not trying to shoot the messenger. In this case, you are the messenger. We are not trying to shoot you down. We are very thankful of your information. It opened up a can of worms. Now, if the can being opened ay walang laman na worm, okay lang rin. Basta tawang katotohanan ang lalabas dito. Yun lang ating gusto talaga. But remember, being the messenger, you still have moral obligation na maparating yung message clearly doon sa intended recipient, di ba? So, with that, again, holiday ko sir, please, due diligence on your part to follow up that informant.